See that reply? I didn't type it. My AI agent built with n8n did it for me. And here's the crazy part. I'm running the whole thing 100% free on Render with Superbase. Stick with me, because in just a few minutes, I'll show you exactly how you can connect your own WhatsApp to an AI agent without paying a single dollar. If you're new here, welcome. I make step-by-step videos on how to use AI and automation with n8n completely free. Today, I'm going to show you exactly how I connected an AI agent to WhatsApp using n8n without paying a single dollar. Now, quick note before we jump in, I already have a separate video that walks you through how to host n8n for free on Render with Superbase and cronjob.org. I'll skip that part here to keep things focused, but I've linked it in the description. If you're hosting n8n locally on a different provider or even on n8n's official cloud, you can still follow along and get value from this video. Alright, let's jump into the setup. On our n8n server, the very first step is to create a brand new workflow. Now, let's add the first piece, the AI agent trigger. We're going to add the WhatsApp Business Cloud node and choose on message. This trigger lets our workflow actually communicate with WhatsApp. But here's the catch. To connect, we need credentials, and those come directly from your Facebook business platform. Don't worry, I'll walk you through exactly how to get them. So open a new tab and type business.facebook.com. Hit enter. On the sidebar, you will see a drop-down list of business accounts. If you don't have one yet, that's fine. Just create a new business portfolio. Fill in your details, portfolio name, first name, last name, and email. Then click create. Once your business portfolio is ready, head to your dashboard. Click settings. On the sidebar, under accounts, click apps. Here, you see a list of all your apps. Now click add, because we're creating a fresh app just for our n8n WhatsApp AI agent workflow. Next, create a new app ID. Type in your app name. For example, I'll call mine n8n AI, but you can name yours anything you like. The email feed will already be filled in with your default email. You can change it if needed. Then click next. For use case, look at the sidebar and select others. Choose others again, then hit next. Now, we need to pick the type of app we're creating. Here, go with the business type and click next again. Finally, you'll see a summary screen with all your details. Double check everything, then hit create app. And now you've got your Facebook app set up, which means in the next step, we'll grab the actual credentials and plug them into n8n so your workflow can start talking to WhatsApp. Wait for the app creation process. In just a few seconds, you'll be redirected straight to your app dashboard. Now that we're on the app dashboard, let's add WhatsApp to the app. Under Product, click the Setup button in the WhatsApp card section. On the left sidebar of the WhatsApp product page, click App Settings, then select Basic. Here you'll find the credentials we need, the app ID and app secret. These two credentials are what we'll use to connect our WhatsApp trigger inside n8n. Here's where it gets exciting. Go back to n8n and click Create New Credentials inside the WhatsApp trigger. For the client ID, paste in the app ID. Next, return to your Facebook App Settings tab. Click Show App Secret, authenticate your account. Then copy it. Head back to n8n. Paste the secret into the client secret field and click Save. You should see connection tested successfully. That means your credentials are correct and working. For the sake of this tutorial, we'll just add a simple AI agent. But stay tuned, because in upcoming videos, I'll show you how to build more advanced AI agents with way more power. To start, add a new node and search for AI agent. This node will become the powerhouse of our WhatsApp bot. For now, let's leave the settings as they are. We'll come back to them shortly. Now, here's the key part. Our AI agent needs a chat model to think, process, and respond to messages. To add one, click the chat model node inside the AI agent. From the list, choose OpenRouter chat model. We're going with OpenRouter because it gives us free AI models that can handle real conversations, perfect for building a chatbot without extra cost. Now, before we can actually use OpenRouter inside n8n, we need to set up our API key. So open a new tab and go to openrouter.ai. If you don't have an account yet, quickly sign up, it's free. In my case, I already have an account, so I'll just sign in. Once you're signed in, click on your profile picture in the top right corner and select Keys. Here, you see an option to create a new API key. Give it a name, something simple like n8nai, and then click Create. Now copy that API key and go back to your n8n tab. Inside n8n, select Create New Credentials. You can also rename these credentials if you want to stay organized. In the input field labeled API key, paste the key we just copied, then hit Save. If everything worked, you should see connection tested successfully. Perfect, that means we're ready to move forward. Next, under Model, scroll until you find DeepSeek. We'll be using the DeepSeek free model version 30324. This is the one that's completely free. Select it. Now let's test it quickly. Click Execute Previous Node. You'll notice we get an error. Don't worry, that's totally normal at this stage. By the end of this tutorial, we'll fix everything and have our AI agent working smoothly. So definitely stick around. One more important step, our AI needs a memory node. This is what allows it to remember past messages and reply with context instead of acting like it forgot everything every time. So, drag in a memory node and set it up as simple memory. By default, the context window length is 5, which means the AI only remembers the last 5 messages. Let's change this to 10 so our agents can reference a longer conversation history. Now, let's connect and adjust the node. Before we continue, let's quickly fix a problem that only happens if you're hosting n8n on render. If you've tried running a workflow that includes WhatsApp nodes, you might see this error, bad request. Please check your parameters. Don't worry, it's not your fault. It's actually a render-specific issue. Here's the fix. Go to your render project. Open the environment variables section. Add a new environment variable. I've added the link you'll need. Just copy and paste it into the new variable. Once you save it, that error should be gone and WhatsApp will work smoothly in your workflows. Alright, now that's fixed, let's move on. Now, for our AI agent to actually respond to messages, we need to add one more WhatsApp node inside n8n. This time, it's the WhatsApp Business Cloud to Send Message node. But here's the key difference. This requires a new credential, separate from the one we set up earlier. Specifically, we'll need two things. An access token. A business account ID. So let's grab those from Facebook. Head back to your Facebook app dashboard tab. From the sidebar, click on WhatsApp, then API setup. Here, click Generate Access Token. You'll see a pop-up, just continue. Then choose Opt-in to all current and future WhatsApp accounts. Hit Continue and then Save. Now, copy your access token. Switch over to your n8n tab and paste it inside the access token field. Next, return to your Facebook app tab again and copy the WhatsApp business account ID. Paste that into n8n under business account ID, then hit save. For the sender phone number, simply use the drop-down to select the loaded number. This should be the same number from your Facebook app account. Now let's test our setup. Open WhatsApp, you can use WhatsApp web or the mobile app, but here I'll be using WhatsApp web. Paste the test number to start a chat with your AI agent. At the send message node, let's first add a fixed recipient phone number. Don't worry, we'll change it later, but for now, we just need to test if everything is working. Enter your WhatsApp number and don't forget to include the country code. Next, let's return a simple success message. Now, execute the previous node and then open WhatsApp. Send a quick message like hi to our bot. At this point, you'll notice an error, no session ID found. This tells us that the WhatsApp trigger is working fine, but the simple memory for our AI agent isn't 8. Why? Because it needs a session ID to keep track of conversations. So let's fix everything step by step. First, go to the AI agent node. We want it to be dynamic, meaning it should take the message directly from WhatsApp and respond to it. Change the prompt source from connected chat trigger node to defined below. Under messages, drag the body field from the WhatsApp trigger into the prompt. Now, execute this step. What happens? The user's WhatsApp message is now passed directly to the AI agent as a prompt. Next, we still need to fix the session problem. Head over to the simple memory node. Just like before, change the prompt source from connected chat trigger node to defined below. Now, go back to the AI agent node. Copy the prompt expression you just created there. Return to the simple memory node and under key, switch from fixed to expression. Paste the expression you copied. Finally, in that expression, replace text body with from. This change ensures that every user's phone number is used as their unique session ID. That way, the bot remembers who it's talking to, message by message. Now let's run the workflow. Click Execute Workflow and watch it in action. On WhatsApp, the first thing we see is the word success. That tells us everything is connected properly. Next, we'll switch the response to come directly from the AI agent. The AI agent will process whatever we type and send a reply back. Here's how we do it. Go to the WhatsApp trigger. Under messages, drag the field from into the recipient phone number. This makes sure replies go straight to whoever is chatting with the bot. Now clear the text body. Instead, drag the AI agent's output into the text body. Execute again. This time, instead of success, you see the AI-generated reply inside WhatsApp. And that's it. Our n8n AI agent is fully connected to WhatsApp. All you need to do now is set the workflow to active. From here, you can ask the AI anything. For example, explain AI. And you get a full response directly in your WhatsApp chat. Powerful, simple, and 100% automated with n8n and AI. And there you have it. We just built a complete WhatsApp AI agent with n8n step by step. This is just the beginning. From here, you can expand your workflow, connect more apps, and even automate your entire business without writing a single line of code. If this tutorial helped you, make sure to like this video, subscribe to the channel, and turn on the notification bell so you don't miss the next automation guide. And if you know someone who would love to try AI on WhatsApp, share this video with them. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.